this video, we will show you how to set up your RME audio interface with Studio One. First, install the driver for your RME audio interface. If you haven't done this already, you'll find the link to our downloads page and the appropriate driver in the video description. After the successful driver installation, open up Studio One and go to Setup to configure your audio device. Select your RME audio interface both as a playback and recording device. When creating a project, you are able to specify the sample rate. Device block size is important for controlling the time delay you hear when you record audio signals while simultaneously listening back to them over your headphones or speakers. This time delay is often referred to as latency. Latency can have a great effect on recordings. When the latency is too high, musicians often feel like they are dragging behind the beat. Reducing latency is therefore key to a natural and great recording. So the smaller the buffer size, the smaller the input lag while recording and playback. A round-trip latency of under 10 milliseconds is usually barely noticeable for most musicians. Please note that a smaller buffer size will also increase your CPU load. Hence, it is really well advised to use a smaller buffer for recording, but increasing the buffer for mixing situations. Once you created a song, the song setup lets you set all relevant parameters for your RME audio interface. Apart from the sample rate, you can assign all inputs and outputs for Studio One under the tab Audio I/O Setup. For a better overview, you get a simple routing matrix. The horizontal row shows all available channels from your RME audio interface. The vertical row, on the other hand, represents the channels for Studio One. So you have a nice overview of what is currently going on. All that is left to do now is to add as much channels as you need for recording and playback. Studio One will automatically route the channels in ascending order, which you can later change, of course. If you want to create a headphone output, go to the output settings and activate Cue Mix on the appropriate channels. On the vertical line, you can see which channels are designated for headphones on your RME audio interface. To start your recording, add a track, select the desired input channel, arm the track, and engage recording. Note that all output channels in Studio One will show up as their respective software playback channels in TotalMixFX. If you are not familiar with this concept, please watch our dedicated series. Thanks for watching.